I need to say this before we proceed with this video. I have been heavily affected by this game's recent news of it being shut down. I know it sounds incredibly dramatic, and it probably is, but just, I feel like I'm losing something from my, like, teenage years, the tail end of my teenage years anyway. And all those memories I had are tied with this game, and it actually hurts knowing that I will not be able to find new friends on this and experience it ever again come April 29th. So it really has been actually kind of tearing me up these past couple days. I'm gonna miss this game, and it was really fun, and I highly recommend that if you haven't at least tried it. It may not be the best thing out there, but before it's gone, give it a little respect and just send it off properly with at least giving it a shot. That's enough of the sappy shit. Let's go ahead and get into the video. So what actually happened with this game? Well, the better question is, what didn't happen with this game? It was launched in such a poor state, which was really infuriating given the absolute lack of MMORPGs on the Xbox 360, at least that were available to me. As far as I remember, Phantasy Star was also on the 360, but I don't believe I was able to download it for some reason, and I have actually no idea why, so my options were limited. I mean, seriously, picture this for a minute, right? It's 2013 and you just got done playing some Mass Effect 3, then you see this open world MMORPG for the Xbox 360, an MMORPG, right? The closest thing you had to that was like GTA and like the first Red Dead, which are not RPGs per se, they're just open world. And you have my background in MMORPGs coming from an entire family that plays WoW, and at the time I didn't have a PC to play anything really, so seeing an MMORPG on an Xbox 360 was literally a godsend to a person like me. Now this is where the sad boy hours comes in. So I booted the game up and it was just depression. Every 10 minutes or so, I am getting disconnected or I can't even get into the game. And I know what you might be thinking. You're like, oh, the game was really popular and that it broke the servers. Not even a little bit. The game was poorly optimized with a lot of technical issues that ranged from server disconnects or game-breaking bugs. Matchmaking would sometimes just throw you out of matches, and for whatever reason, it still hasn't been fixed to this very day because my previous video, kind of playing the game, that happened again, so that still is a problem. I'm not even sure what happened. The whole lobby just exploded while I was mid-dungeon, and it just gone with the wind. I have no idea what happened and how it hasn't been fixed in this many years. Then you had the biggest problem, which was script glitches, which is the in-game currency to buy stuff, and there was bugs where you could get millions of the currency, which was absolutely insane given this is an MMORPG that had a competitive game mode for PvP. That's like fucking Black Desert Online having a million silver glitch where you can just buy anything and everything at a consistent rate for like a straight 3 years. You know how vastly different that game would be with everyone rocking pens? I know we all would like that future, but like it would be a pretty different game and it'd be quite boring. So everyone starts abusing all these glitches and gets endgame gear, and all the new players are just getting stomped out by the guys that have abused this glitch until the Netherrealm can't fit these fucking losers. Another annoying issue I remember is that the achievements for this game were barely functional, and to this day, I'm pretty sure they are still not fit. Which obviously they're not gonna get fixed, but I imagine it wasn't on the top priority list given the overwhelming amount of other game-breaking things that were available, so I guess I'm not surprised, but it's just that's another thing for annoying issues because people were achievement hunters, especially during the 360 years, right? That was achievement hunter central, so it was kind of just sad that you couldn't really get a lot of the achievements, and the ones that you were working towards did not register, and you wasted all that time for actually nothing. Now this next issue is probably the start of the end right here. When the game first released on old gen consoles, the new gens were on the way. And just as a reminder, I know people are really into gaming now, but back then it was not as much as a demand and there wasn't scalpers, or at least there wasn't a whole lot of scalpers. So getting an Xbox One or a PlayStation 4 was fairly easy to do. You didn't actually have to wait months. There wasn't a bunch of people trying to sell them on eBay. There wasn't a whole just mass extinction in less than 6 minutes. So I just need to, I just need to give you that information, all right? So the original Defiance was released back on April 2nd, 2013, and new gen consoles were launching in November 2013, which is just bad timing on their part, given, the game was made for the 360 and was already a mess on there, and new consoles with newer games that were far better would just eclipse Defiance into obscurity. I mean, Destiny 1 was around the corner from Bungie in September 2014, and keep in mind, this was when everyone had faith that Destiny was gonna be fucking good. The next issue that happened, which came in 2015, was the show Defiance getting canceled by Syfy due to financial reasons after completing the third season. Yes, this game Defiance is supposed to be a show adaptation of the Syfy series Defiance, which was an interesting something back in those days. Just to touch on the series for a moment, the pilot for Defiance is this incredibly lengthy two-part long thing. I'm gonna keep it real though, it's no Game of Thrones or Vikings of course, but shit was kinda cool for its time. I will say the CG and the actor lineup, not doing it any justice by any means, but I did watch all of it, and I watched it actually a couple times. I even showed it to a couple people. I remember when I was dating this girl back then, I had her watch it too, just to show it to her, and she even thought it was pretty good. So, I mean, it wasn't all that bad. I mean, at least judging by for me, but yeah, there was definitely parts about it that were not so great. Now, the reason the show getting canceled was bad is because the show's numbers were not doing too hot, which meant traction to the game wasn't going to be either. If the show had taken off and had garnered some sort of Game of Thrones level of success, we might have a totally different game right here. But that didn't happen, so here we are. I used to ask people that I met in the game if they knew what this game was about, and not a single person I remember ever told me that they watched the show or knew that this was a show adaptation. So that's always good. They just got randomly lucky and found it in the Xbox 360 store and just happened to download it and give it a try. So at least people were giving it a shot and a chance, so that was decent. Let's fast forward to 2018 now, and Defiance 2050 showed up on my feed one day in the horrifyingly gross space as the Xbox Marketplace. Now, I nearly lost my shit thinking this was a sequel due to my lack of knowledge at the time. I downloaded this game and holy shit, it's the exact same buggy mess from 2013 with some extra content that's just as buggy as everything else. From that point forward till today, it has been in a state of obscurity, only reaching players that decided to dive into the abyss known as the Xbox Marketplace. Even with all these negatives though, I stuck with it. I'm gonna keep it real. I stuck with it and played it for a very long time, and I made a lot of friends and even joined what I believed at the time to be the top clan or guild that was present during those years, and it was really cool just to run around with friends and do arc falls and go around and goof off in PvP. I even remember back in the guild, we used to make our own races and we would have like parkour challenges and stuff, and the winners of the challenges, the guild leaders would actually drop us legendary gear, which for me at the time, that was so cool because I had never been a part of any kind of community that ever did anything like that. And they had hunting parties for these gear pieces so that way they could run these events, and it was a very lively community, and it's so upsetting that there's nothing like that out there. I loved that. That was probably the thing that made me love the game the most, was that I met people that were so dope that they would farm in-game items and buy in-game items just to drop for guild members that participated in guild activities. Like, they were trying and they were putting their foot forward every single time, trying to do something and keep the game alive. And that's why I love this game, and it was great for the time that it was. It may not have been perfect, it may not have been top tier, but god damn it, it did wonders for me. And during those years, I was going through divorce, thinking I was gonna lose my son, and luckily for me, he's still here to this day, and Defiance is gonna be gone, and I'm just in a broken state right now. I am just upset. I will always remember this game, and I loved it, for better or worse. Goodbye, Defiance, and thank you for making my tail end of my teenage years not actual hell, because it was literally total hell back then. Thank you guys for stopping by, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.